Good morning. You're welcome today to the broadcast of the prophetic word. I'm Pastor Mark Akiti, your regular host. God bless you. We give God praise today, Wednesday, 11 August 2021. God will make today a special day, a day of blessing in your life and family, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you today for waking us up alive and well. And Lord, as we discuss your word and pray today, we're asking that your mighty presence be released upon our lives in Jesus' name, and you bless us beyond our imaginations today in Jesus' name. Thank you for answering us, Lord, for we have prayed with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen. We'll take a Bible reading today from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 9. 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 9. But Saul and the people spared Agag, and the best of the sheep, and of the oxen, and of the fatlings, and the lamb, and all that was good, and would not utterly destroy them, but everything that was vile and refuse, that they destroyed utterly. Today's thing, the series of our special teachings, deliverance, that we are teaching today, we are continuing on that same area. Today we are talking on the arrow of disobedience. God gave King Saul a specific instruction. It says in verse 3 of 1 Samuel chapter 15, it says, go and smite Amalek. And God told him and said, utterly destroy all that they have, spare them not. God said, kill man, kill woman, kill cattle, kill goat, kill everything. God said, don't spare anything. But Saul went into the battle, and the devil knew that they can't stop. The only way he can stop Saul is to make him disobey God. And the devil fired an arrow of disobedience into the life of Saul. And when Saul got into the battle, he began to kill the animals that were no good. The ones with bent leg, he killed them. Animals that are blind, he killed them. When he saw good ones, good oxen, good sheep, good goat, good lamb, all those good ones, he kept them aside. He kept the king aside. He said, I want this one, I will use this to appease God. I will use this to give an offering. But that was not what God told him. God said, kill everything. He went to the battlefield and did something else. And God told him, for this thing that you have done, God said, so to obey is better than sacrifice. We were better obeyed. But your disobedience, his disobedience cost him the kingdom. His disobedience cost his whole lineage the kingdom. They missed everything. And because an arrow of disobedience was fired into his life, and he obeyed. Balaam wanted to curse the people of Israel. Balaam and Balak, they built altars, seven altars with seven rams, seven this, seven that. They were building, spending money to curse the people, and they could not curse the people. At the point, Balaam cried in Numbers 19:23, he said, there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there divination against Israel. So everything he tried, all his enchantment, could not work against the people of Israel. His divinations could not work against the people of Israel. And Balaam talked to Balak and gave Balak an idea, and told Balak, the only way you can get these people is to fire an arrow of disobedience into their midst. What did they tell him? He told Balak, send your beautiful women, send your beautiful ladies to the camp of Israel. Let them go and meet with them. Let them display their beauty before them. And those Israelis, they like fine women. Just send them. And truly, Balak sent the beautiful women into the camp of Israel. And as they saw those women, they began to make friends, girlfriend, boyfriend. Before you know it, those women dragged them into their gods. They began to worship Baal with those girls. And God got so annoyed that God killed 20-something thousand in one day, in a single day, out of anger. What the sacrifices could not do, the arrow of disobedience did in a single day. the arrow of disobedience crush in a single day. In Genesis 39, verse 7 to 13, the story of Joseph. Then you and I know we are popular with this story. God has blessed Joseph. Joseph is in the house of Potiphar. Suddenly, the woman, beautiful woman, place her eyes on Joseph. She doesn't want her husband anymore. It's Joseph that she wants. And every day he keep telling Joseph, Joseph, lie with me. The Bible says he kept telling her him every day, Joseph, lie with me, lie with me. And yeah, I know. Imagine, look at those Egyptian women, Egyptian ladies that we see even in films. See how beautiful they are. And look at what Satan projected to tempt Joseph. Why don't you just enjoy this thing? After all, nobody will see it. After all, your master will not see it. Lie with me. Lie until Joseph said, no, I can't do this. I will not do this. This arrow, an enemy is shooting this arrow. I will not sin against God. I will not disobey God. But the plan of that arrow, if Joseph accepts, is to just sin against God. Joseph refused. And because Joseph refused, he was thrown into prison. But thank God, if Joseph had slept with that woman, his destiny would have ended in Potiphar's house. If Joseph had slept with that woman, Joseph would not have gotten to Pharaoh's palace. Joseph would not have gotten to where his dream would be fulfilled. That place would have become his final bus stop if he had obeyed to sleep with that woman. That's the danger of these wicked arrows, arrows of disobedience that will cut you short, cut you off from the plans and purpose of God for your life, to derail you so you will not get to the place that God has ordained for you. If Joseph has agreed, that will have been the end of his story. That will have been the end of all his dreams. Everything will have just ended. You could have even died. Maybe the same woman would have told the husband things about Joseph and they will kill him, and that will be the end of his story. But thank God, Joseph did not bow to the arrow of deliverance, to the arrow of disobedience. Today, my advice to everyone, hearing the sound of my voice, whatever that will make you arise and sin against God, say no to it. Say no to it. Because if the devil knows that he cannot stop you, then he will make you do something that will make God curse you. He will make you take a step that will make God get angry with you. If he knows that there's no other way, he will force you to sin. He knows he can't cost your finances. You know he can't cost your finances. He will make you do something. Maybe tell you, eat up that tithe. Don't pay that tithe. Don't pay it. And he knows the consequence, what God has placed on it. And by so doing, the evil consequence flows into your life. That's just what the devil does. His own is to shoot an arrow of disobedience into your life and make you disobey God. Today, I pray for you in the name of Jesus. Every wrong step, every sin you have ever committed that turned your bus stop into your destination. What should be a bus stop and you are lingering at that same spot for years without moving forward because of the wrong step you have taken, because of disobedience, in the name of Jesus, today the mercy of God will snatch you out. Today the mercy of God will rescue you out of that situation. Today the mercy of God will rescue you out of that Potiphar's house. The mercy of God will rescue you from that situation where the enemy held you in, and further will be the end of your story. The mercy of God will rescue you from that setup, will rescue you from that situation in the name of Jesus. When you see people misbehaving, doing things they ought not to do, and enemy has shot an arrow of disobedience into their lives. When you see children acting, doing things that they ought not to do, most times you pick in, it's good to flog children or flog them, but know that most of these things have spiritual connotation. Go into prayer, begin to uproot the arrow of waywardness. Uproot arrows of waywardness, arrows of waywardness, arrows of negativity, arrows of addiction, arrows of evil. Begin to uproot such arrows from the life of those children, and you'll be surprised that God Almighty will take those children and do work wonders in their lives in Jesus' name. Today, once again, I pray, let the power of God reach out into every area of your life, into your family, into your home, into your children. Every arrow of disobedience that have been fired into the life of those children, I command that arrow to be uprooted now. You evil arrow, jump out by fire in the name of Jesus. You arrow of disobedience, jump out by fire in Jesus' name. Any power that wants to make you make the wrong decision or take a wrong step that will truncate your family, a wrong step that will cause problem, in the name of Jesus, by the power and the blood of Jesus, we cut off that step in Jesus' name. Any demon that will maybe pushing you and say, no, now you have some money, why don't you go and take a second wife so you can enjoy yourself more, so that to bring storm into that home, you will not take that decision, you will not take that step. The power of God will rescue you from bondage in Jesus' name. And any strange woman outside firing an arrow into your life so you can be lured into their laps, just like the Balak sent those beautiful ladies into the camp of Israel. The power of God will cut them off from your life in Jesus' name. I release the power of God's deliverance upon you today in Jesus' name. You will not fall a prey to the arrow of the wicked. You are delivered from every plot of the wicked one. You are delivered from all the schemes of the wicked one in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I soak your life in the blood of Jesus. I soak your family in the precious blood of Jesus. I soak your children in the blood of Jesus. And as you go out today, I soak the work of your hands, your business, and everything you are doing for a living, I soak it all in the blood of Jesus. I pray you will succeed. There's somebody God is asking me to pray for. He says near success syndrome. Any person, each time you want to succeed, something cut off your success. You invest so much, at the point of reaping, suddenly everything just crumbled. That spirit of near success syndrome, I cut it off now in Jesus' name. I set you free from every satanic manipulation in Jesus' name. If the Son of Man shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. You are free in the mighty name of Jesus. You are free in Jesus' name. Amen. If you are listening to us today and you've not given your life to Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ is the only way. Say after me, oh Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Have mercy on me and forgive me all my sins. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Father, for saving me. If you have made that confession, you are born again. It is well with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. You can reach us to our telephone number +234 8058 000442, or send us an email, god@answersbyfire@gmail.com. This message is also available on Telegram. You can search for our channel on Telegram, Prophetic Word and Prayers, and click join channel, and you'll be receiving these messages on Telegram. Also, you can get this audio. There's a format we have on YouTube. You can get it on YouTube. Our channel on YouTube is Flamites Television. Just click that channel, join that channel, subscribe to that channel, like the videos, and you keep getting messages on us in Jesus' name. Remember to share this message to everybody in your contact. It is not just a message you are sharing. It is the blessings of God that you are distributing to all these people. And they will thank you. They will be grateful that you did. Don't keep it to yourself. Spread the good news, and God will bless you. In the name of Jesus, I leave you with this word. Don't settle for less. There's more to come. I will see you again tomorrow morning. Shalom.